हेलो क्लास 11, दिस इज योर सब्जेक्ट अकाउंटेंसी, चैप्टर नंबर 8, सोर्स डॉक्यूमेंट्स ऑफ अकाउंटेंसी, लेक्चर नंबर 1। बेटा, इन दिस लेक्चर वी शैल स्टडी द डिफरेंट टर्म्स ऑफ सोर्सेज डॉक्यूमेंट्स ऑफ अकाउंटेंसी। लेट्स सी। द सोर्स डॉक्यूमेंट इज द फर्स्ट रिकॉर्डेड डॉक्यूमेंट फॉर ट्रांजेक्शन। फाइन। So in this document, all the important details like date, amount, party's name, the nature of account is to be reported. Fine. So only from source document, all the entries in other books are recorded. Understood? So let's see. All cash memo. What do you mean by cash memo? You know, cash memo is a document which is issued to record the cash purchases of the business. It includes quantity, rate, total amount of goods sold, along with the date of transaction. Fine. So it is issued by the seller of the goods. So these cash memos are used to record transaction in the books of accounts. Fine. Basically, we can say that cash memo is prepared while selling the goods for cash. So it contains date, quantity of the goods sold, rate and amount received. So beta, it acts as an evidence for the sale of goods for cash. The office copy of cash memo is an evidence for the business entity that goods has been sold for cash. Understood? Next one is debit note. What do you mean by debit note? You know, debit note, when goods are returned to the supplier, so debit note is prepared and sent to the supplier of the goods. What does it contain? It contains the name of the party, like supplier, whose account has been debited, along with the amount and details of the bill and the reason for the debit, in reference to which account has been debited. Means a debit note is a source document. So a debit note is a source document which is prepared and sent by the buyer of the goods to the seller of the goods. Fine. Stating that this account has been debited by the buyer of the good with the specified amount. Why do we prepare debit note? The reason for preparing debit note may be return of defective goods, or goods is not as per the sample, or we can say less discount is allowed by the seller. Fine. Next one is credit note. Beta, credit note is prepared when goods are received back from a customer. So when goods are purchased on credit, the seller prepares a sale invoice called bill. When goods are purchased on credit, the seller prepares a sale invoice called bill. Fine. That contains the name of the party to whom the goods are sold, as well as the rate, quantity and total amount of sale. So however, a cash memo is prepared when trader sells the goods for cash. So credit note is similar to debit note. It is the only difference between two is that it is prepared by the seller of the goods and debit note is prepared by the buyer of the goods. Fine. So credit note is prepared by the seller of the goods when he received the sold goods back from the buyer. Fine. Or for allowing more discount to the buyer. So when the seller of the goods received back the sold goods from the buyer, he credits the account of the buyer and intimates the buyer as well about credit note. Understood? Beta, when a trader receives cash from a customer, the receipt is issued to him. Fine. Received is issued to the customer when cash is received from him. It's simple term. So, a receipt is issued to him containing date, amount, and name of the customer. It acts as a proof in the hands of the customer that the payment is made to the seller of the goods with the amount specified in the receipt. It's very simple. Whenever we buy any goods, fine, we purchase any goods, definitely we get a receipt. The original receipt is issued to the customer while duplicate copy is kept for the reference in future, which contain date, amount, name of the party and nature of the payment. Fine. Next one is beta, an invoice and a bill. What do you mean by invoice and a bill? An invoice and a bill are documents that convey the same information about the amount owing for sale of the product, or we can say services. But the term invoice is generally used by a business looking to collect money from its clients. But bill is used by a customer to refer to the payment they owe supplier for. Fine. This is the difference between invoice or bill. So it is prepared by seller of the goods because when he sell goods to the buyer on credit, it contains name of the buyer, detail of the goods sold, rate and amount of sales. So original copy of sale invoice is sent to the buyer while duplicate copy is retained by the seller of the goods as an evidence. Fine. This is the difference between invoice or bill, because invoice is used by the business to collect money from its clients and bill is used by the customers to refer to the payment they owe suppliers. Fine. Next one is our pay in slip. Pay in slip means it is a form that is used to deposit money in a bank. Fine. It is a form that is used to deposit money in a bank. It contains a counterfoil that is returned to the depositor after it is duly stamped and signed by the cashier. Fine. So this slip acts as a receipt, contains the detail of the date and amount deposited either through cash or check. So beta, in simple term we can say that pay in slip is used to deposit either cash or check of the customer for collection of payment in our bank account. Fine beta. So it is available from the bank. It has two portions. One pay in slip and another one is counterfoil, which is returned by the bank to the customer after acknowledgement by the cashier. And counterfoil of pay in slip is preserved by the customer, which is, that is the proof, or we can say evidence, that cash has been deposited in the bank. Understood this term? It's very easy. See next term. Next term is voucher. Beta, what do you mean by voucher? A voucher is a written document that provides evidence of any business transaction. It is a source document that is used as an evidence of recording transactions. Fine. Where in the primary books of business like journal or other subsidiary book. So voucher is a written document prepared by accountant providing the evidence of business transaction. The evidence of business transaction is called a source document, like cash memo, pay in slip, check, debit note, credit note, etc. Fine. So let's see next. There are two types of vouchers, one cash voucher and another one is non-cash voucher, that is also called transfer voucher. Cash voucher is also further divided into two parts, debit vouchers and credit vouchers. First of all, debit voucher. Debit voucher are the documentary evidence of cash payment. These vouchers are prepared to keep records of cash payment relating to the business, including capital and revenue payments. Fine. For example, payment of wages and salaries, purchase of goods for cash, purchase of plant by cash, etc. So, debit vouchers are prepared at the time of making payment either in cash or through check. Fine. It is made in following circumstances like purchase in the goods for cash, payment of wages and salary, purchase of investment for cash, making drawings and depositing cash into bank. Fine. Now just see what do you mean by credit voucher. Credit vouchers are documentary evidence of cash receipts. Fine. Debit voucher were time at the time of payment, and these are prepared at the time of receiving payment. Fine. This is the difference between debit voucher and credit voucher. So these vouchers, like credit vouchers, are prepared to record various cash receipts relating to the business. For example, sale of goods for cash, sale of fixed asset or investment for cash, and we can say cash received from debtors, sale of investment, sale of old newspaper, sale of old newspaper, capital introduced in the business, or we can say sale of fixed asset, and we can say withdrawal of cash from bank. Fine. So this is the difference between debit voucher and credit voucher. Now it is the turn of non-cash vouchers or transfer vouchers. Documentary evidence of non-cash transactions like credit transactions. Fine. So these vouchers are prepared to record non-cash transactions of the business. Fine. Example of non-cash vouchers are goods sold on credit, sale of fixed assets, writing of depreciation on sale of fixed asset on credit. Fine. Writing of depreciation or bad debt and return involved. Fine. So it also include credit sale, credit purchase, purchase return, sales return, bad debts or provision for doubtful debts, all these things. Fine. So this is the difference between cash and non-cash vouchers. Fine. So we can understand about the difference between debit, credit and transfer voucher. Fine. Now beta, these were the terms of the chapter related to origin of transaction, and we can say preparation of voucher or source documents of accountancy. Fine. So your homework is you just revise this chapter and note down all these terms in your notebook.